Hey there, teacher Tunti here, and today I'm going to be showing you this cool little flash game, Lightbot. Now, Lightbot is a game which is designed for aspiring programmers. So if you're good at this game, then you should consider learning programming. You can always spot the good students who will do well in programming by the way that they play this game. So there's a link in the description box below, and I urge you to go and try it out. We'll start a new game, and I'm going to show you how to play it. So, the point of the game is to make this robot move onto this blue square and light it up. You don't control the robot directly. What you need to do is that you need to write a program in this grid over here in order to make to tell the robot what to do. So, if I put in this instruction here, move forward, and press go, the robot will move forward once. If I want to move forward twice, then I need to put two arrows. See? You need to put in a full description of what you want the robot to do from beginning to end. And that's what programming is, really. You put in a description for what you want the computer to do from beginning to end, and then you run it. And that's what a program is. It's a list of instructions for a computer to follow. So, after making the robot arrive on the blue square, we make him light it up with this command. And this is the result. See? First level, beaten. Let's see the second level. Okay, now in this level, we need to make the robot go around this block. And you do that by using these two commands, turn anti-clockwise, turn clockwise. So first, we'll make the robot turn clockwise, and then we'll make him move forward. Let's see that. See? Now we need to make the robot turn anti-clockwise, and move forward 1, 2, 3, 4 steps, is it? Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's test this part first, before we continue. Okay, so far so good. Now we need to make the robot go rotate anti-clockwise, move forward, and light up that square. See, it's easy. Anyone can do this. Ta-da! Second level ready. Okay, now in this level, we need to make the robot jump over this small wall. Now, to make the robot jump, we have this command over here. So, we need to make the robot move forward, jump up on the wall. Let's see if that works. Okay, now we need to make the robot jump down from the wall by putting in another jump. See? Now we just make the robot move forward, turn anti-clockwise, light up the first blue square, light up the second blue square, and light up the third blue square. It's important that you write a program that will make the robot light up every blue square in the level. And it has to be the same program that makes the robot move from beginning to end, and ending up with all the blue squares turned into yellow. Let's try that. First, second, boom! Now I'm not going to show you this level. You have to try it yourself. So I'll see you when we get to the next level that I need to show you. Okay, and we're back. Now in this level, we can't do what we've been doing up to now, which is writing programs which fit in this grid, because the program will now not fit in this grid. It's too small. We can't light up all three blue squares by putting commands into this grid. So what we need to do is to continue writing the program into these grids, but these grids don't work the same way like this grid does. So before we get to it, let's show the need. So we need to make robot forward, then jump, jump, turn anti-clockwise, jump, jump, light up, and jump down. See that work? Okay, now, if we continue the program in this way, see, won't fit. Won't fit. We can only make the robot move forward one more time, but we can't make the robot. We don't have any space to tell the robot to light this up, then go back to this square and light that up. So, what we do is we need to put in this command. And what this command will do is that it will make whatever is in this grid work. So we put a program in this grid, we put instructions in this grid, and F1 will make the instructions in this grid work. So we can make the program larger in this way. So what we need to do next is make the robot move one more time forward, light it up. Let's test this out. So fair, here, here, turn down, light it up, and we're in the first function. Now we need to tell the robot to go rotate twice, move forward a few times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times, but we don't have enough space. So what do? We call F2, the second function, and we continue the program there. Okay, let's see that work. See? Not that hard, is it? Now in this level, we need to make better use of our functions in order to write a program that makes the robot light up every one of these blue squares. So, what we need to do is that we're going to give each function a meaning. Let me show you what I mean. I'm going to give function 2 the meaning move forward and light up. So if I call function 2 once, the robot will move forward and light up the first square. If I call it twice, the robot will move forward and light up two squares. So the number of times I use F2 will be the number of blue squares that light up in front of the robot. Now what I'll do is I'll put these in function 2. And I'll give function 2 the meaning light up a whole row of blue squares. So I'll put in 7 calls for function 2. 6 and 7. So when I call function 1 now, all of these 7 function 2s will execute, and that will make the robot light up a whole row of squares. See, function 1 now has this meaning. The meaning is light up a whole row of squares. So how do we light up the second row of squares? We call function 1 again. Of course, first we need to make the robot face that row first. So turn around, move forward, and turn around again. Let's see if that works. Calling the first time, function 1, lighting up a whole row of squares, facing the second row, and calling F1 a second time. Now what's wrong here? The robot moved forward before lighting up the first square. So what do we do? Well, before calling F1, we'll simply light up the square before moving. See? It's easy. Now, notice this number over here. This number is the total number of commands that you have used in your program. Now, I'm not going to continue showing you the levels because I want you to try them out. But basically, you need to keep that number, the score, the number of commands used, as small as possible. Right? So you need to use as few commands as possible in order to pass all the levels. And there are 12 levels in all. And basically, I just beat them all myself. And I used 180 commands in order to beat all the 12 levels. I dare you to use less commands than that. Can you beat all the 12 levels without using more than 180? Well, if you do, leave a comment below, and I'll see you next time.